Halloween! Halloween has always been something very special for me. I just love something about the atmosphere, you know? It's a magical time of the year where we believe silly, crazy things that we'd never believe in everyday life, like that skeletons are real. And of course, what is any great holiday without its share of holiday movies? I could go on and on about all the great, creepy classics that you could go and revisit on Halloween, but why do that? Now, instead, I'm gonna talk to you today about Spooky House. So, a little backstory. My cousin has been telling me about this movie for a while, and he keeps telling me we should watch it, and now that I've been doing this show, he gave it to me so I could examine it, and ooh boy, I wish he hadn't. And I know that this is the perfect type of movie to examine this time of year, to get that spooky nostalgia way up there, except it's not really nostalgic. I'm also, like, convinced it's one of those ring situations. I'm pretty sure that now that I've watched this, I'm gonna be dying very shortly. Of course, that could be entirely unrelated. I'm not a very healthy individual. Ugh. You ever commit just a little too hard to a bit? So yeah, we're gonna watch Spooky House because it's the perfect thing to, you know, get everybody amped up for the Halloween season. I'm gonna do it anyway. Okay, so I'm gonna watch this, but I got one problem here. It's November. I need to get this place, you know, spooked up a bit. Blue, perfect. The spookiest color I can think of. The color of... Watch Spooky House.
Thank you. Thank you. It's good to be back. Be prepared to have your illusions shattered.
Right off the bat, I have some problems. So, through this very long and slow intro sequence, we are introduced to the main character, or one of the main characters of the movie, the Great Zamboni. The Great Zamboni. And we're also introduced to his wife, Native American stereotype. I mean, Dawnstar. Dawnstar.
Legend has it that Dawnstar was ready to be born a human being. When an evil spirit saw how beautiful she was and decided to take her as his wife. But the ancient spirits of the sky and the earth said no.
I feel like that's probably what I should have said when somebody handed me this.
No. So the evil spirit took her and hit her.
Wait, he what her?
Hit her.
Well, he probably shouldn't be doing that. He sounds like a real bad guy.
Looked upon the star. And blue with all his might.
Holy shit! Jesus Christ! So basically the whole point of this is to show that Ben Kingsley used to be a magician and his wife slash assistant got blasted by God into oblivion with a bunch of head turn Foley effects. That's not how you react to that situation. That is not how you react to that situation.
No.
Oh, okay. Enough of that. Let's get on with the show. This sounds like Michael Jackson singing a song about
he's a little creepy, always acting free.
Michael Jackson. I just love that a minute ago this was just a serious sad story about some dude's wife exploding out of nowhere and now it's just
Spooky House. Have you heard the rumors?
Hey, I'm not complaining, this is my jam.
Watching you,
and if you're
to take the chance. You
be the spooky guy.
You wanna try that again?
It's me, the spooky guy.
Spooky house. No one's gonna save it at the spooky house tonight.
What about a different night? You know, what if I come back on like weekdays? Is it like some sort of union thing or?
Spooky!
Yeah!
Spooky guy, spooky guy, spooky kids! Like, if you ever just walk by a public place and there's just a bunch of children with their faces pressed up against the glass following you with their creepy dead little eyes, like, they're the spooky ones. This is ageism.
Okay, 1/5 plain cheese, 1/5 with everything for guess who, 1 with everything but anchovies for Max, 1 with pepperoni, and 1 with caviar for Zoe.
I'm convinced if you call any pizza place in the world and order that, they will come to your house and personally beat the shit out of you.
Hey Mom, Prescott, Yuri, and I want to go to the clubhouse, so can you watch Max and Zoe?
I'm going to go to the clubhouse.
Me too, I'm going to go with Beans.
Hey, come on, it's our clubhouse, it's for big kids.
It's not fair. It's ours too.
I want to go too, because they're taking me away soon. They're taking me away soon.
So here we meet our main cast of kids, and there's this one kid in the group who...
Hi, what are you, mother?
At least you have a mother.
Is amazing. This kid who plays, I guess, the main character is the highlight of the movie. His, just the lines they give this kid to say and just the deadpan way he delivers all of them. It's not supposed to be funny, but it is by far the funniest and best element of the movie. So, I you know, A for effort.
There's nothing you can say that will make me change my mind. No.
How about if we give you half our candy on Halloween?
Yeah.
All right, deal.
Cause he's fat. So it's here that we meet some of our villains of the movie, this girl and her two dumb friends, and let me tell you, these two are fine, they're there, but this boy right here, he is the star of the show. This is hands down the best actor in the movie.
His boss been like dead bodies and stuff?
Open it.
Open it?
Yeah, come on, just open it.
Well, I don't feel like opening it.
As you can see, the dialogue here is just magnifique.
Okay, does anyone have a match?
What would we need a match for?
Duh.
Ah, yes, duh. How could I forget? Let me just... It's not helpful. So it's about this point that we meet the person that all these idiots work for, a character who acts as their boss. This character is fittingly named Boss.
And don't call me Boss. Call me Madam. Boss.
Oh, sorry, Madam Boss. My mistake. And let me tell you, the performance of this actor is just...
Even the fact that the entire contents of your mind could be chiseled on the head of a pin, my suggestion to you is the less said, the better.
Existent.
Perchance you are beginning to regret that having waded in so far, you cannot now go back. What can I say? But tough kazookies.
Well, you could say literally anything else because that's not a saying.
This, if you move up and down, the mugroom will cry, cry.
It's not fair. Why do I have to go to the orphanage the day after Halloween?
That's actually a good question. That's a very specific time frame.
Hail to the blithe cigarette.
Hey lady, are you alright?
I totally didn't just see you standing on top of your car a few minutes ago while I was driving down this road.
So Boss uses her idiot kids to steal cigarettes from the cigarette delivery man in his cigarette delivery van. You know, the local cigarette delivery man who rides around in the cigarette delivery van. Come on, you know.
Whoa, that CPR stuff sure works.
It's okay, Max. You can share our mother anytime you want, big guy.
Well, where are we going with this? Am I gonna have to turn this off? Please say yes.
Hey, Dipwad. Where'd you get the goat on a rope?
Oh, they don't like us.
Hey, yeah, why don't you guys like us anyway?
This kid is pretty much just me in any social situation. Isn't that one hurt?
I have better stuff in store for these little dorks.
I don't like you!
Hey! Watch it!
Honestly, this kid's great.
Duh. Well, what's his name?
Princess.
She's a heezo. You can't call a guy princess. That's gonna be one screwed up goat when it grows up.
There's gonna be one screwed up kid when it grows up.
Well, you know, she's right, you know, Mom. I mean,
you know, there's a reason why they call you specifically Dumb Dave.
Yeah, I was thinking about that. Why is that?
This honestly feels like these kids weren't given a script. Like they were just sort of told the broad strokes of what they had to get across, and the director just never yelled cut, and he was off in the woods doing coke with Madam Boss.
Oh, he threw up rubber puke, man. How'd he do that? Yo, I think he must have eaten like a lot of junk food or something.
Somebody help this kid. He doesn't know where he is. Like, some people just walked up to him and were like, you want to be in a movie? He's like, I guess I can be in a movie. I'll probably be sleeping under the bridge. So these kids go around, you know, screaming the goat's name throughout their neighborhood because they're just the worst.
So we cannot keep doing this. We have to go home.
I just love how easily everybody gives up in this movie. You're not gonna do this. I firmly believe this. Okay, man.
Princess! Princess!
What the hell was that? So the kids chase the goat around some, and it's here at 20 minutes in that we're finally introduced to the titular spooky house. And ooh boy, spooky is... that's a word for it. They use like this... I can't tell what it is. It's either like a miniature or a matte painting.
He's really a vampire. And he's be 2,000 years old.
Yeah, and the house is full of snakes.
With human traits. They got emotions and they cough and they watch TV shows.
So the goat gets into the house and all these kids decide that instead of doing anything that makes sense, they should all just break and enter. Sorry, let me put that in correct context. This kid decides to go in and all of his friends just enable his horrible behavior.
Real ghosts, spookier than the spooky guy.
I know all that stuff.
So why do you want to go in there, Max?
Because I had nothing to live for anyway.
Okay, never mind. I guess we gotta do it now. This kid's gonna grow up to have some issues.
Come on, guys. We're not afraid of that old spooky guy, are we? Are we? Yeah?
That's a compelling argument, but it's okay, though, because the spooky guy watches from far away and does nothing to prevent this. Oh, no. I know how things in Hollywood have been going recently. Ben Kingsley, get those kids out of your house. Oh, good, you turned off the day for night filter.
Hey, Sir Lancelot, it's a room full of dummies, and I'm not one of them.
Look, this little asshole didn't even go in. What a dick.
Guys?
So you're probably starting to notice by now that a lot of scenes in this movie go on just a little too long. Like, they all seem like they should have been cut off just a hair shorter than they ended up being cut off, and it makes the movie feel very weird. Ah, yes, let me just look through my secret panel that functions exactly like a camera. So the kids run around the spooky house and proceed to get spooked, and this one Russian kid is eaten by a couch, and then this happens. Thank you. honestly, this is the scariest thing in the whole movie. But seriously, I gotta compliment the people who did the set design on this stuff, because it looks really great. I mean, there are some shots in here that look like they could be straight out of a Mario Bava film. But you know, like a really bad one.
Guys, let me know if you see an ugly red guy, pitchfork, tail, horns, ghost, witch, vampire, anything out of the ordinary. Just let me know.
What if there is be flying rat? You mean a bat. Okay.
Oh, okay, I'm glad they kept that scene. You know, we can't see the part of the scene where the girl loses the goat again, but we got to keep that scene! So anyway, these kids continue their breaking and entering and wander just like all around this guy's house, and instead of doing the sensible thing and telling them to, you know, get out of his house, he decides to rise up out of a coffin and shoot fake lightning at them. And Max is just like, not impressed at all. Point that Max does what any normal kid would do. He descends further into the hellish nightmare of a house that this strange man has built. Now, I really can't blame the kid. Ben Kingsley seems to be completely unaware that there's a string of words that gets people out of your house. It goes, "Get out of my house!" So the kid looks around at all of the great Zamboni stuff.
It's not stuff. This wand that you just dropped was once a part of the private collection of stuff.
So he looks around at all the great Zamboni's stuff and instantly falls in love with the place, immediately saying,
"This place is wasted. This is a great place for a kid to live."
Wow. Just wow.
Wow.
This kid just breaks into somebody's house and then just immediately starts going, "Hey, you know what? It would be really great if I lived here." This kid is the Christopher Columbus of the modern era. So the kids go surfing on the internet.
Going surfing on the internet.
To try and find out more about the great Zamboni and eventually come across video footage of his last known performance. You know, the one where his wife went all... So Max goes to the great Zamboni's house and finds him chopping down a tree wearing a turban and a false mustache. As you do. Max even seems to purposely injure himself just for a chance to get into the spooky house and start squatting. Oh yeah, and then he spends like a literal minute trying to figure out how to work a band-aid. Kid, you know, if you can't figure out a simple adhesive strip, I don't know if magic's really your thing. You might want to go to like working in a toll booth. So Max continues to harass Ben Kingsley until he eventually gives in to showing him a few magic tricks, and thus starting their bonding relationship. And like any good budding relationship, Max decides to further it by going over to the guy's house and planting a tree in his yard without his permission.
I dug it up myself. I think it needs to be watered a lot.
And then proceeding to tell that man that he just has to take care of it. You know, Max is just really an upstanding kid at this point. So the idiots come by and steal the goat again because I think they were just making this shit up as they went along, and the children go to enlist the spooky guy to get it back because he seems real eager to help.
No!
Oh no, the jaguar's tail is stuck in the couch and it's really hurting her!
She won't eat us, she's friendly.
Spooky guy's coming!
How do you know that? You're outside! Max frees the giant cat, but ends up getting stuck in the couch himself.
Max did save her.
What is this? Would you go, all of you? Would you just go? I don't want to see any of you near my
spooky house! No!
So then something truly... something happens.
I hate children. I hate children. I hate children.
That's right. Just in the middle of his show, in the middle of doing his whole thing, just...
I hate children.
No.
So as a reward for helping the jaguar out of its own stupidity, Max is gifted the Wand of Houdini, which, really, that should probably be in a museum or something, right? So then Max rides around with the wand like a little weirdo, and those three idiots show up and beat the crap out of him because he's being a little weirdo, and also this screenwriter just wants to prolong my torture. Seriously, we're like an hour in and I don't even know what the hell's going on. Hey, yeah, so whatever, they take the wand and then, oh!
Leave him alone! Stop it!
Let's split.
Stop it!
Defeated by the bullies, Max goes to the spooky guy for help, and he actually doesn't act like a dick to him this time, so that's a change of pace.
Have you ever been picked on by bullies?
Yeah, my whole life.
And why are you a bully?
Me? I'm not a bully.
You hate children.
Who told you I hate children?
You did. It's the last thing you said to your wife before she disappeared.
Just like at every opportunity, he has to piss this guy off. It's like it's all part of his master plan. It goes, you know, get into guy's house, piss guy off, home.
My mama, before she got sick, she used to tell me not to fight, so nobody ever wins.
Well, I never knew my mother, so I'm not as lucky as you. There was nobody there to tell me not to fight. And because all the other kids always picked on me, I got into a lot of fights. I had a great right cross. So I spent a lot of time in the basement.
Oh yeah, that's normal.
I didn't see the show because I was in the basement.
Let's not react to that at all. So over this really long exposition scene, Ben Kingsley basically explains that he met his wife and his wife wanted to have kids and he didn't want to have kids, which we now understand that's why he. That still doesn't explain why. So we find out that he just really didn't want children, and then now everything's cursed, and it's just a whole ordeal. So that's where we're at in this story. So now it's Halloween. Ooh, perfect. This is, you know, we're an hour in, and you know, it's been mostly painful so far, but now we're getting to the good stuff. Now we're getting to that spooky atmosphere I like. Yeah. But this really weirdly creepy out of place scene just sort of pops up at an hour into the movie.
As soon as you left to go get my water, these two boys came in and they stole all your candy. And I tried to stop them, but I couldn't.
Oh, that's all right, dear. It's not your fault. You know, the same thing happened last year. Some poor girl, she looked so sweet in her angel costume. She was so upset.
Well, it's a shame there's kids like that out there.
It's not fair to the other kids.
Like, what the hell was that? So meanwhile, all the other kids are running around doing the normal trick-or-treat shenanigans. And wait, wow. How the hell did that kid get a movie-accurate version of Ben Affleck's costume in Batman v Superman? This kid is years ahead of his time.
That's it. I've had it. I forgot how hard trick-or-treating is. You gotta walk up to every house. Some have steps.
He's fat! Do you get it? But now, because this movie is just a collection of things happening, the kids see the other kids stealing from the houses and decide to follow them so they can find their goat because, oh yeah, that's part of the plot. So then the kids see Headscarf Lady giving everybody just a showcase in hand acting, and Max decides that now would be a good time to just make a shitload of noise and steal back his wand. So this leads us to our climax, or at least I think this is the climax. It's kind of hard to tell what's going on. The older kids decide they really want to get that wand and goat back, so they decide to break in the spooky house as well. But little do they know that the kids are conspiring with Mr. Spooky himself, or whatever the fuck his name is, so that they can scare the... What stupid fake word? They can scare the Kazookies out of them.
No. Oh man, I'm not going up there. I hate spiders.
Those ain't spider webs.
I didn't think he finished the line. So then the older idiot kids walk around the house, you know, all the typical stuff that you think is gonna happen happens. You know, things pop out of them, blah, blah, blah. You know, we're very far into this movie and barely anything spooky has happened at all. You know, I need something really spooky to happen real soon or I'm just abandoning all hope completely.
Open.
It's locked!
What's that?
Just a spooky day. I'm a cool day. I'm just a spooky day. I'm a cool day.
Never mind. 10 out of 10.
Spooky.
scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight.
You know, there's actually a lot of fun little tricks here, and you know what, that's what this brief little moment is. It's fun, it's pretty fun, and of course, what else can you follow up this fun moment with than brutal child evisceration? I can't think of a more natural leap. Oh yeah, and then this happens.
Hello. Would you like blood cocktails?
Like everything else that happens in this whole sequence, I can accept. I can accept that there's these, like, secret tunnels and passageways. I get all that. Like, they established that. But, who the hell is this? Is this an actor? Is this a real vampire? Where the hell did this guy come from? Does he just live in this guy's house and he only comes out every once in a while when he needs to scare the shit out of some teenagers? Wait, does that make this a common occurrence? Because, you know, earlier when they were coming in, he didn't really stop them. Like, he just sort of welcomes this, so he has this guy on the payroll, he has this guy waiting in the wings, but he's not like a main player, because we haven't seen him before right now. I have so many questions about this one little thing. I don't even care anymore. The movie really peaked with the skeleton dance, like any movie with a skeleton dance does.
Why is Shadow so good? Why doesn't she bite people?
I don't know, really. I found her on my doorstep one night, and I thought she was a shadow at first.
Well, that was very stupid of you.
I did all I could to find out where she came from, but nobody claimed her. Nobody knew anything about her.
Does this guy think that if a jaguar randomly shows up at his door, some guy's gonna come up a few days later and be like, "Oh, thanks, you found my jaguar. I was looking for that." So then the three bullies go down the music tube. I don't know what else to call this. This whole long, drawn-out scene of him trying to scare the stupid kids, and they don't really seem scared or afraid or anything. So it kind of leads you to believe that it's going to go in the direction that they're going to be like, this isn't scary, and they're going to have to figure some way out of it. But no, this kid just pisses himself, and then they run into this room. Yeah, that's right, I didn't edit that music in or anything. They just go into this weird hypnotism room and they start listening to that Vengabus song that was in all those Six Flags commercials. And it's making me wish that the guy from those commercials would just hop out of them into real life and just kick me in the throat. We only got like 20 minutes left. I think we can make it. So I guess where you think the movie would be wrapping up, Madame Boss shows up again and she's all like mad because... I don't know, who cares? They have just a really unimpressive sword fight, and then the great Zamboni wins. Yeah, yay, everybody's happy, except that lady, but who cares?
And I'd like you to get the fuck out of here!
I'm gonna miss you, Max.
And then, so even after all of that, Ben Kingsley still does the same thing to do with a crazy downer child who just keeps breaking into your house and demanding to live there, basically tells him to fuck off. You know, that's not unnerving at all, just receiving a book filled with child's drawings of yourself. That's totally normal, you know? It's no cause for alarm. Don't look into that. But the kid asks the great Zamboni to do a magic show for his orphanage, and eventually, after receiving all these creepy drawings, he decides to do it. And instead of being just a quick little scene, we get to watch the whole magic act. So then he does this whole big thing, and yeah, of course you guessed it, he decides to adopt him, his little, like, you know, Stockholm Syndrome play work. Max is gonna have a home, whoop-de-doo. So anyway, the movie's wrapping up, like, you know, it's been a bit of a drag, but at least it's finally coming to a close. I mean, we got about, like, what, 7 minutes left? There's no way that this is going to continue to drag on, right? That's right, we find out that the great Zamboni's pet jaguar this whole time has been his wife. Think about how many things that that cat has had to have seen throughout the years that are now going to have to just be talked about and explained. Like, there's been a lot of stuff that that lonely man has been up to that he's gonna have to answer for. This happiness is very short-lived, and my happiness is never coming back.
I found in Dawnstar's rocket.
Whoa. I knew it was real magic.
No,
it's over. It's over! Okay! I'm gonna be honest, I never thought I'd see the day. Woohoo! Wow! Anyway, would I recommend Spooky House? No. That's my Spooky House review. I hoped you guys liked it. Obviously, I did want to get this video out in time for Halloween, but, I got stuff I'm doing. I've got my Patreon up too. I'm setting up more rewards and more exclusive stuff that'll be coming as I build more content here. So if you could check that out, I'd be really grateful. Help share the video around, that really helps out. These videos are a lot of work, takes a lot of work to edit them. I love doing them, I can't wait to do more. So help get the word out about the show, because I really appreciate that. And I look forward to making more episodes for you guys. I'm really excited for the stuff I'm working on that is going to be coming out soon. Still working on my movie. I'll put the links to the GoFundMe and the trailers and all that stuff in there. And thank you all so much for supporting the show and supporting my channel and just being the wonderful people that you are. I'm going to go to sleep, because it has taken a very long time to film this video, and I'm done.
Oh, also please subscribe. Thank you.